Hearty greetings to all my precious students of grade 3. Just as I had promised last week that I'm going to start with the poem of English literature. Okay. That is number 2 poem, that boats sail on the rivers. Now this poem is written by Christina Rossetti. Okay. Before we start this beautiful short poem, let us briefly analyze the background of this poetess. Okay? She is a poetess, Christina Rossetti. You can see there is a brief information about the poetess. Okay, let us read. Christina Rossetti, she lived in these years, that is from the year 1830 to the year 1894. Okay, she lived briefly through these years. Wrote her first poem when she was 11 years old. So you can imagine that she is poetess to the core. Such a small child of 11 years writing her first poem. Okay. When she was a child, she spent a lot of time observing nature. A true nature lover. Okay. And she used to spend a lot of time observing her surrounding, observing nature. Rossetti has written many poems for children as well as for adults, that is the grown-up people. Adults are the people who are grown-up, and for children like you. Okay, she has written many poems. Okay, now let us start this poem. Before that, we see what the warm-up session has for us. Do the clouds floating in the sky make you think of boats and ships sailing in the sky? Okay. Now, clouds that are floating in the sky, you see clouds, okay? During daytime, if you observe the sky, you will find clouds in different shapes floating in the sky. And when you look at these clouds, do you think that they resemble some other objects that are sailing? Yes, you can compare the clouds to the boats and the ships. Okay, and these boats and ships, they sail in the water. Why so? Imagine what it would be like to take a ride on a boat of clouds. Okay, now they have compared that these clouds are like a boat, and if given a chance, okay, you have to imagine, it is just a pure imagination, you have to just imagine that you are offered a ride, and a ride in a boat of clouds, so that you can sail across the sky. Would you like to take the ride? Yes, of course, why not? What would you see and feel? You will see the whole world if you are up in the sky, and you will feel as free as a bird. Isn't it? That sensation, that feeling itself is so much overpowering. Yes or no? Join in a group and share your thoughts. So you have to imagine to yourself that you are offered a ride, and the ride in the boat of clouds, and you have to sail in the sky, open sky. Okay. Next, the poet praises the beauty of the sky on a clear day. Now, just as we had seen that the poetess Christina Rossetti, she had this beautiful habit of observing the nature. So before writing this poem, probably she is observing the beauty of the sky on a clear day. Okay, not the monsoon sky, it's a clear sky, clear day, and she is praising the beauty of it. And after it, she has probably, maybe she has started writing this beautiful poem. It is a short poem, as you can see, only two paras, and within this two paras she has beautifully described the beauty of the sky. Okay, and you can see the nature is so much more beautiful. You can see this beautiful sky with the rainbow. Okay, and there's a river flowing, and you can see boats sailing on the river. This is a river. Okay, and the boats are sailing in the on the river. Okay, next let's start reading this poem. Boats sail on the rivers. Okay, you can see the boats are sailing on the river, and ships sail on the seas. Now the sea is a bigger water body than the river. Okay, river is smaller than sea, obviously, because the rivers are small. We can see the boats sailing through the river, and the ship, the ship is capable of sailing in the sea water because it is bigger than the boats. Okay, and the river is the seas are bigger than the river. Okay, and the seas and ships sail on the seas. So these are the water bodies, and these are the things that sail in these water bodies. Rivers have boats and seas have ships sailing on it. Okay, but the clouds that sail across the sky are prettier far than these. So you can see that these water bodies have these elements floating on it, but now when it comes to the sky, what do we see sailing across the sky? Yes, the boat of clouds. Okay, the clouds, you can see in the clear sky, you can see the clouds sailing across the sky. Okay, and now the poetess Christina Rossetti, she tells us that these clouds that sail across the sky, they are far prettier than these man-made objects like boats and ships. Yes or no? Do you agree with her? Yes, I agree completely that the clouds are of different shapes and sizes, and they are far more prettier than the boats and the ships built up by man. Okay, next. There are bridges on the rivers. Okay, you can find the bridges, man-made bridges. They are built across the rivers so that you can go from one end of the river to the other end. If you want to go to the other side of the river, you use the bridge. You walk on the bridge and then you reach to the other side of the river. Yes or no? Okay. As pretty as you please. So we have lovely bridges built across the rivers, and these bridges are more sophisticated, more modern. As much prettier as you can make a bridge, you can build up a bridge as pretty as you want. But the bow that bridges heaven and overtops the trees and builds a road from earth to sky is prettier far than these. Now, which bridge, which is this bow, which is the bow bridge that is built from the earth to the sky? Yes, just as you guess it right, it is a rainbow. Now the poetess has called this rainbow as a bridge. Bridge that is built built to bridge the earth and the sky. That is our land to the sky. It is an imagination. Okay, pure imagination of the poet is that this rainbow is a bridge. Do you think that the rainbow is a bridge? No, it is not a bridge. It is just an imagination of the poetess that this rainbow is a bridge, and this bridge is built between the sky and the land, between the heaven and the earth. Okay? And this bridge, that is this rainbow bridge, is more prettier than this man-made bridge. This man-made bridge is built on the river. Okay, it meets the gap between the two ends of the river, but this rainbow bridge, it meets the gap between the earth and the sky. It is just an imagination of the poetess. Okay, and then she also tells that this rainbow that bridges the heaven, it can be seen on top of the tree, overtops the tree, means it is far more at a bigger height. The tree is smaller and this rainbow bridge is overtop it, on top of the tree. And she is also telling that this rainbow is far prettier than this man-made bridge. Okay, now did you understand the poem? The poem is sweet and very short, easy to understand. She is telling that all the elements of nature, that is the clouds, the rainbow, they are far prettier than the man-made boats, the man-made bridges. Because why? God has made these all, clouds, rainbow, yes or no? And what all things God has made, it is far prettier than what we human beings make, yes or no? Okay, now let us read one more time and then we wind up this session. Okay, boats sail on the rivers and ships sail on the seas, but the clouds that sail across the sky are prettier far than these. There are bridges on the rivers as pretty as you please, but the bow that bridges heaven and overtops the trees and builds a road from earth to sky is prettier far than these. Yes or no? Let us read one more time. Okay, one more time. Let's go. Boats sail on the rivers and ships sail on the seas, but the clouds that sail across the sky are prettier far than these. There are bridges on the rivers as pretty as you please, but the bow that bridges heaven and overtops the trees and builds a road from earth to sky is prettier far than these. It is such a beautiful poem written by Christina Rossetti. Okay, now all the meanings of this poem, as you can see, it is given at the back of the, okay. Now let us see bow. Just as I told you, bow means a rainbow that you can see when it is raining and all of a sudden the sun shines. Okay, it is a half circle with seven colors which sometimes appears in the sky when the sun shines after the rain. Just as I told you that it's raining, all of a sudden the sun shines and then you can see a beautiful rainbow. Now let me tell you, the rainbow is made up of seven colors. Seven colors are named as Vibhyor. V for violet color, I for indigo, V for blue, G for green, Y for yellow, O for orange, and R for red color. These are the 7 colors. Okay. Vibcure, V-I-B. G Y O R. Okay, this is a short name for all the colors that the rainbow has. 7 colors: violet, indigo, blue, green, yellow, orange, and red. These are the 7 colors. Okay, next, bridges. Now, bridges are the structures that are built over rivers, roads, etc. so that people or cars could go across them. Just I told you that if you want to travel, if you want to go from one end of the river to the other end, you have to take the help of the bridges. And these are the structures. These are made up for traveling, exclusively traveling, so that people and cars can go across them. Okay, overtops are the stretches above the height of something else. It's more heighted. Overtops means the rainbow is at a greater height than the trees. Okay, sail is to travel in a boat or a ship which has a sail. Sailing means you are traveling in a boat or a ship, exclusively over water body. Okay, that's all for today. Happy reading, and try memorizing this poem. It's a lovely poem. Try memorizing it. Happy learning, happy memorizing. Bye.